Hello students, here is the question. So if you look at this question, here we need to find the incorrect statement. And if you look at the options, if we are able to rule out any one of these, we might be able to actually get the option due to cross-reference. So if you look at option A, electric monopoles do not exist where magnetic monopoles exist. Now this option is only in option D. So if this option A is incorrect, then option D is definitely incorrect. So let's look. Electric monopoles. Now we know electric monopoles, meaning they're talking about a proton and an electron having a positive and a negative charge individually, respectively. And we know these monopoles, that is a single pole, definitely exist as we have them in the nucleus. So this statement is definitely not correct. And the second part, that magnetic monopoles exist, is also incorrect because of observation that when a bar magnet having a north and the south pole is cut, it does not give us north and south pole separate, but it makes smaller bar magnets having both the poles intact in them. Okay, so option A is incorrect, which means option D is incorrect in the options that we need to choose. And if you look, we have been given option A and B, and over here B option is the common. So let us look at the B option. Magnetic field line due to solenoid at its end and outside cannot be completely straight and confined. So this statement is definitely incorrect, because over here we can say that the magnetic field line due to a solenoid at its end and outside cannot be confined. And this statement says it is confined. So this statement is incorrect. They are not confined. And if you look at option C, magnetic field lines are completely confined within a toroid, which is correct because toroid is a spring and which is joined on both its ends. But this line over here, this line is equivalent to a spring wound like this. So this line actually represents this thing. And if you look over there, we can see that if the ends are joined, there is no place for the magnetic field lines to come out of the toroid. So option C is correct. If we look at option D, magnetic field lines inside a bar magnet are not parallel. As we know, magnetic bar or a bar magnet has a magnetic field lines diagrams or something like this. And we know that these actually meet up with the poles on the opposite side. So if we have this as a north pole, the magnetic field lines attached to the south attached to the pole at the south end of the bar magnet. So these lines have to be straight inside. And also option D is incorrect because they have said it is not parallel. So option D is incorrect. And if you look at here, A and B are definitely incorrect because B and D are incorrect, which means only C and E are correct. That is, for perfectly a diamagnetic material, the magnetic susceptibility is equals to -1. Thank you.